Good afternoon and welcome to another online organ recital presented by me, James Flores. I'm very excited and thankful for you to watch my video. If you could leave a like and subscribe to my channel, that would be greatly appreciated. Consider it as your virtual ticket to this recital. Today's program only consists of two pieces, but it doesn't mean we'll be cutting this recital short. The first piece is Mendelssohn's Third Sonata. And this is probably my favorite Mendelssohn sonata because of its grand first movement. And it finishes off with a quieter second movement. Of course, I love all the six Mendelssohn sonatas. And actually a former teacher of mine, Dr. Alan Beavis, he exposed me to the Mendelssohn sonatas, and I vividly remember the recital he gave in Albury a few years ago where he presented the six Mendelssohn sonatas, and being up at the console and turning pages for him, I got to experience firsthand the musical journey of Mendelssohn's organ works. This is my first Mendelssohn sonata that I've ever played publicly in its entirety, and I shied away from them for a long time because I wasn't quite sure how to register these, and there's so many different editions of the Mendelssohn sonatas. But not long ago, a friend of mine from Sydney, Sam Giddy, came to Albury to give an organ recital, and in one of our conversations I mentioned the Mendelssohn sonatas and how does one register it. It's confusing, there's so many different interpretations. Well, he simply said to me, just register it with a nice, clean, bright sound. So that's what I'm going to do here today, and it really simplified everything for me and inspired me to sit down and learn this marvelous sonata. So I'll play the Mendelssohn and then we'll talk about the next piece after this. Enjoy. What a beautiful ending to this sonata. We often think of grand pieces like the, like a sonata to end quite big. So ending on a quieter note often has a lot more emotional impact. Actually, my mind was actually wandering when I was playing this, which it shouldn't have been, but after the energy of the first movement, I kind of let my mind drift. And I wanted to say, yeah, this, I'm using photocopied sheets. Well, they're not photocopied sheets, they're, it's an edition I found on IMSLP, and I learnt the second movement a long time ago. And if you're a musician, you would know when you play from a different edition, even though the notes are the same, just the layouts of things just make it a little bit difficult. So instead of playing it from the edition where I learned the first movement, I just inserted my other public domain edition here for the second movement. So that's why I've got the photocopy sheets. We'll now move on to Denny Bedard's Cat Suite. And as the title suggests, this is probably not a work you should be playing in the liturgy or at mass or at a service. It's a recital piece, it's a secular piece. And Denny wrote this for his cat in 2005. It's titled here, In Memory of My Beloved Cat, Francis, 1984 to 2005. It's in four movements, the first being a prelude, and that's spelt with a few extra R's to indicate pairing. The second movement, Cats at Play. The third movement, Catnap. And the final movement is Toccata, so toccata, but a play on the words. I'll drink my coffee that makes me look unprofessional in recital. And yeah, so I will play this piece without any breaks in between the movements, and then we'll discuss how it went afterwards. Just finding my registrations here. Wasn't that a fantastic ending to this suite called the Cat Suite? It's such a fun piece to play, and I'm sure you can imagine what the cats are doing in each of these movements. There's a piece on the piano that I used to play. It's called The Cat and the Mouse by was it Khachaturian? No, Copland. Oh, I can't remember who it was, but this type of composition reminds me of the piece like The Cat and the Mouse. And that concludes to this afternoon's recital, and I really appreciate you coming to listen. If you're watching with me live, it's been fun chatting with you in the live chat. I'm going to add an extra couple of minutes at the end of this video, so we can wrap up our conversations. And also a big thank you to Sonus Paradisi. I actually didn't mention that the organ we're using this afternoon is the Marcussen Rotterdam organ. It's a very famous organ. Very popular amongst Hauptwerk users. It's very, very versatile. And yeah, I thank Sonus Paradisi for the sample set they have donated to me, so I can provide you with an excellent sounding organ recital. And before we go, make sure that you could like and subscribe to my channel. And if you would like to buy me a coffee, there is a link to PayPal in the description. And there's also the option of becoming a patron on Patreon, where you'll receive backstage access to my life as a musician and a whole bunch of other stuff that's not published to the public and just within the Patreon community. Thank you, and see you next time.